right against the rumble. And then hanging out at the corner to the right is the okapi, the closest cousin to the giraffe. Hiding way back there in that corner. The okapi has the same bone and skull structure as the giraffe, as well as the same tongue type. It's so shy and reclusive, it was not discovered by the Western world until 1901. Up the hill to the left is a black rhino. That's a really rare sight. We'll be getting a lot closer. Now, at one time in the world, well, now actually, there are less than 5,000 rhinos, black rhinos in the world. They are poached for their horns, which are made out of keratin, the same thing as our hair and nails. There is one laying down right there. How about that one? We'll see that one instead of the one up on the hill. If you don't see it, it's the boulder laying down. The one with the ear.
Everyone went, oh.
Yeah. Now there's another one up on the hill. Right up there. Do you see him? Now, there are less than 5,000 of these rhinos, but we are working with Foundation Blue Cross Africa to provide veterinary care, rehabilitation, and protection for these rhinos to hopefully get that population built back up. Those rhinos grow about 3,000 pounds, which is actually pretty small. And they have a triangular-shaped top lip. Now, walking into the bushes over to the left is a bongo. Okay, I'm not seeing the front half of the bongo, but there's the back half of the bongo, that orange colored animal going into the bamboo. The bongo is known as the ghost of the forest because it has horns pushed back against its head, so it can get into the brush and bramble much quicker and quieter. Now we are going to be heading into the Safi River area. And the Safi River area is home to a lot of really aquatic loving animals. Does anyone know what may be found in a river in Africa?
Snakes.
Crocodiles, that's a good one. Snakes, yeah. Anything else?
Hippopotamus.
Hippos.
No, not alligators, but hippos, yeah.
No, not alligators.
How about to the right? There's one swimming. Sorry, guys, we're going to get closer to him. He just dived under that water. Look at that beautiful hippo over to the right, swimming under the water. See the shadow? That's the hippo. The hippo grows up to 5,500 pounds, and they form groups called bloats. And look to the left, there's a bunch. Bridge up ahead, guys, so we've just got to wait for that truck in front of us to get over that bridge. Alright, now it's our turn to slowly make our way over the bridge. Over to the left are the Nile crocodiles.
Wow, look at those crocodiles.
And the Nile crocodiles will open their mouths to regulate their body temperature. They will snap. different jaws and stuff, so that's way cooler to see it in person. Now, up ahead and to the right will be the baobab tree. I'll tell you exactly when we get up to it. The baobab tree is known as the upside down tree because it looks like it has roots reaching high into the sky. It can grow for thousands of years and it's leafless 9 months out of the year. Those baobab trees are used by elephants in times of drought as a source of water. The insides are made of pulp and water, so they bore into them with their tusk and then bite into it. That's to the right. Right here is that baobab tree.
Right there. Is that cool?
The baobab tree. Now we're going to slowly start making our way in here. Not too fast. We're heading into the Serengeti grasslands. The Serengeti grasslands stretch across most of Africa and are part of the wild Africa we are striving to conserve. They are a complete ecosystem. Elephants will knock over trees, eating the leaves, letting it root to new root. While giraffes will jump high into the trees, eating the leaves, letting it slide. Their song. to the right. Does anyone know what that is?
No.
Yes, it's an elephant. Good job. I know you used your animal spotting guide. The elephants will flap their ears to reduce their body temperature. They can reduce it by up to 15 degrees. If not, one of the things our researchers have been researching is elephant communication and behavior. And they have discovered that elephants are afraid of bees. Yes, elephants are afraid of a bumblebee. I think I see something up ahead, guys. But it's gonna be really hard to spot. You have to listen. Okay, look, right now that pile of brush by the fence line laying down is a cheetah. It actually looks like there are two cheetahs up there.
What is a cheetah?
Can you see them? It's really hard to see. I'm gonna go slowly past. You should be able to see it between the tree.
Right there.
Do you see it? It just flicked its tail.
Right beside
it. Oh, yeah. Oh, it just sat up. Do you see it?
another one is
yeah,
next to the hut.
They do. There are
to the
two
left
there
of the
that
hut.
Makes it a coalition. It's a group of cheetahs. And cheetahs have great camouflage. You wouldn't think that they would, but they really do. And those cheetahs run up to about 65 miles per hour average. And they can only do that for a couple hundred yards because they are sprinters. Now, up to the left are kopje. Kopje are large rock formations that predators will use as a lookout point. Predators like the lions love the kopje. The lions are inactive for up to 20 hours out of the day. They're basically large house cats lounging around, not doing much. But at night, the females will do most of the hunting while the males protect the pride. Oh my goodness, over to the right are the white rhinos. We're going to get a better view of them around the corner, as well as the other animals that might be over there. So we're going to slowly make our way around this corner. Right around here.